How's it going, Ram fans? Welcome back to your Thursday night sports show, The Blitz. I'm Litos Castro, filling in for Brendan Fairbairn. Tonight, we're going to take a look at the scheduling options for Rams football after the recent cancellation of their matchup against UNLV, as well as some of the highlights from last night's NBA draft. So, let's get started. Now, another cancellation. Wednesday, the Rams football team had yet another one of their contests called off, with the Mountain West announcing that the UNLV at CSU matchup slated for this Saturday will not be played due to pandemic-related concerns. But unlike with their first lost game of the season against New Mexico, Rams head coach Steve Addazio is open to making up the gap in their schedule against an outside opponent. According to Yahoo Sports reporter Pete Thamel, the first-year lead man is open to playing any program available as long as the Mountain West approves, saying, quote, "We want to play football. I just want to try and keep developing our football team as long as the conferences agree," end quote. With Coach Addazio's willingness to play in mind, as well as the already 14 college football games across the nation canceled for this weekend, Fort Collins natives have to be thinking there has to be a team out there to play the Rams, right? Well, luckily for CSU fans, there seems to be some possible options available, both inside and outside the Mountain West. First off, the Rams weren't the only squad inside the conference to see their plans to play on Saturday fall to the wayside. Heated border war rivals, the Wyoming Cowboys, also saw their scheduled matchup for this week canceled on Wednesday against the Utah State Aggies. With both programs now on an unexpected open week and current Mountain West guidelines that currently favor keeping play within the conference, this quick bronze boot rematch might be the most likely avenue for Ram football this weekend. And then we have the out-of-conference option. That's getting the most buzz around Colorado. A makeup of this year's Rocky Mountain Showdown. A match against the Buffaloes that was originally scheduled back in September before it also got canceled. Being around 50 miles apart, the rekindling of this iconic clash between these two in-state institutions is a natural fit for a makeup game, at least geographically. But at the end of the day, it's all up to the respective conferences to agree upon before Saturday. And according to the Bay Area News Group, the Pac-12 is currently amidst discussions to lift their conference-only scheduling guidelines, providing an extra glimmer of hope for both CU and CSU faithful to see these two squads duke it out after all this year. And in the end, tomorrow's news will determine whether the Ram football squad will be stuck at home for the second time this season or if they'll end up on the gridiron. Now, sprinting past the college ranks and into the pros, the 2020 NBA draft that was initially set for months before the professional basketball was thrown into a bubble, quite literally, finally took place last night, ushering in another wave of young hoops talent. And while this usual selection process had Commissioner Adam Silver remotely announcing picks from ESPN's facilities down in Bristol, Connecticut, this evening wasn't without excitement for basketball fans. Starting things off with the first overall pick, Anthony Edwards out of the University of Georgia was the pick at number one to the Minnesota Timberwolves. The 6'5" athletic guard is an explosive presence who physically dominates inside with his massive 6'10" wingspan and his elite step back game from mid-range. Ultimately, Edwards' ability to change direction on a dime allows him to create a shot from nearly anywhere on the court and should fit in well with franchise staple Carl Anthony Towns as well as D'Angelo Russell. Now, the Wolves might have just assembled a big three in Minneapolis. The draft's best player talent-wise might have actually been taken at pick three. LaMelo Ball, the brother of current New Orleans Pelican Lonzo Ball, fell right into the lap of Charlotte Hornets owner and basketball icon Michael Jordan. And with elite size and for a point guard at 6'6", unmatched vision and overall passing ability, it's clear to see why one of the game's greats decided to scoop up Ball early on in the first round. With this being said, there are definitely some negatives in the 19-year-old's game, from his shooting struggles, lack of effort on the defensive side, and maybe just the fact that he hasn't played in an official basketball game in a little under a year might be a problem. But still, though, experts praise Ball's raw talent, and time will tell whether he'll create a spark in Charlotte that hasn't been seen since the departure of Kemba Walker. And for the final guy I want to cover tonight, let's talk about the last pick of the draft at number 60 in the second round. Sam Merrill, who was picked up by the Pelicans before quickly being traded to the Milwaukee Bucks. After his 4 years at Utah State, Merrill is for sure someone CSU fans remember after his dagger three-pointers against the Rams in Moby Arena, both last year and in 2018. He might not be the most athletically gifted guy, but with his excellent shooting and basketball IQ, the former Utah State Aggie shooting guard has a chance to push for a roster spot on the Milwaukee Bucks team that is desperate for some extra talent on the bench. Even as a late round pick, Merrill might still be able to find a place as a 3-point specialist. Well, Rams, that's all the action I have for the final Thursday night sports show of the semester, but don't go anywhere because Angel Cooper is up next to talk about all the spice from the last few days of entertainment.